Hello, everyone, and welcome to Lying Around Connecticut with Carol and Harry. I am Carol Kearns. My husband, Harry Hsu, is our co-host. Our mission for the show is twofold: to provide information about Connecticut Lions events and to showcase the many different organizations and causes that Lions support locally, regionally, and internationally. Harry?
Good evening and welcome. Please consult our website at www.lions23b.org or your district spirit for more information on coming events.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to Lying Around Connecticut with Carol and Harry.
Welcome back to the Fidelco Ride for Independence. What a great event this is every year, isn't it, Carol?
I look forward to it. I love motorcycles.
On with the show.
En avant.
I'd like to ask our host. Last year, we moved the start of this ride to Jengris Harley-Davidson. The Jengris family has been very kind to us, very supportive. They allow us to use this great venue, and it seems to have given us a different view and improved the ride a lot. So, Joe, would you just say a couple words? Joe Barone, General Manager of Jengris Harley-Davidson.
Good morning, everybody. How you doing? So I want to thank you guys all for coming out today. I want to thank Elliot and everyone from Fidelco. I'm the general manager here, and I've been here for about 7 years, and that's about as long as we've been partnering up here. So it's really excited to be part of this this mission here that Fidelco is moving towards. And you know, they really do an incredible job of creating awareness and raising funds for something that has changed so many people's lives. And being part of the motorcycle community and industry for many years, it's never ceased to amaze me how generous, caring, and giving this community is. And it makes me really proud to be part of it. None of this would be possible without all the men and women who volunteer their time, all the sponsors who've partnered up, and with Fidelco, of course, and all of the riders that attend every year to make this fundraiser so successful. So give yourselves a round of applause. Now, Fidelco has dedicated themselves to this mission of breeding, training, and placing guide dogs to those that are visually impaired. And this has changed lives for so many and will continue to do so because all of you for so many more years to come. So let's enjoy this beautiful day on our motorcycles and help raise some money for an amazing cause. Thank you.
Thanks, Joe. Kurt Nelligan from Nelligan's Auto provides this wonderful stage at no cost and is a big supporter, and he keeps our 23 vehicles with over 3.5 million miles on the road every day. So Kurt, thank you so much. And of course our presenting road sponsor, Trantolo and Trantolo. Anybody that's done this knows you can't do it without this great organization and Norm. And when I had this idea 7 years ago, because I've been doing this for a long time, he said, you gotta talk to Norm. He knows everything about motorcycle riding. That's fine. So we set up a meeting in my office in Bloomfield, and this guy comes in with a great big smile on his face and two crutches under his arm and an enormous brace on his leg. And I thought, motorcycle expert? But apparently it had nothing to do with riding. But Norm has been great. Norm will have the very last word about what we're going to do today, but I think I'll turn it over to brothers Keith and Scott for a quick word. How's that?
Thank you, Elliot. How's everybody doing today? All right, thank you very much for coming out. Unfortunately, there's not much left to say. You guys like checked all the boxes already. But I just want to thank each and every one of you for coming out. This is our 7th year sponsoring this wonderful event. I did want to make a quick shout out to the Fidelco staff who trains these wonderful animals. Let's give them a round of applause. Without them, these dogs wouldn't be able to do what they do and provide the services they provide. So thank you. And each and every one of you for coming out today once again. Have a very safe ride. I'm going to keep this short and sweet. Turn it over to my brother for 2 seconds.
Thank you. I just want to say I hope you all are safe out there. Enjoy the ride. It's a beautiful day. Thank God for that. And once again, thank you to Fidelco for all the support that you provide all these veterans. Thank you again.
Yes, and as we get to the other end for lunch, please do thank every one of the Fidelco staff. They're all wearing staff t-shirts, and there's a lot of volunteers who are wearing gray t-shirts. These events don't happen with the small organization that we have if it wasn't for volunteers supporting our terrific staff. They'll all be on the other end, and they'll all be looking forward to shake your hand. We are privileged that so many people trust the staff, the volunteers, and the elite dogs that we breed and train. And I am proud to introduce a true American hero. He would use that word. But Matt spent almost 20 years in the Air Force. He enlisted, he was a bomb hanger for 9 or 10, went into the reserves, came back and said, I want to be an EOD tech, explosive ordnance disposal. He volunteered. They said, no, we want you to hang bombs. He said, no, this is what I want to do. They said, no, we want you to hang bombs. He said, I'm leaving. And they brought him back. So Matt spent 3 volunteer tours of duty in Iraq. He disarmed over 100 IEDs, and I think the last calculation I saw was 150,000 pounds of explosives to keep our troops safe. Matt was significantly injured in 2007 in Kirkuk, Iraq, became a Fidelco client in 2010. He's allowed us to be an exceptional partner to him by providing him with an exceptional guide dog. Ladies and gentlemen, Tech Sergeant Matt Slade, United States Air Force, retired.
Thank you very much. Is that good? Can you hear me? Wow, every time he reads all that stuff off, I'm just like, that just can't be me. That's too many numbers. It's still, it's those things that I think I did it for so long and so intently. When I look on it in hindsight, I'm like, that was stupid. And but more fun than I ever had. I miss it more than anything I could say. My true regret is that I'm still not out knocking out bombs and just doing the job and being in uniform. I loved what I did. You know, as you said, I was wounded in 07, October 24th of 07. This year will be, you know, my 10-year anniversary. And what I can say, though, is you know, I'm the end user, I'm the end client of this whole process of developing these magnificent guide dogs, is that I can honestly say that the doctors were keeping me alive physically, you know, the psychologists and my therapist, you know, were keeping me on my psych meds, but I was not thriving. I had no purpose anymore. I was blind, I lost my dominant arm, my 17-year career that I loved more than my very life was over. All my long-term goal, you know, I was gonna do 30 years, be a chief, retire, get out, gonna be a contractor for Blackwater, make tons of money, and be a mercenary. I had it all laid out. And, you know, and then bam, you know, it was over. And I found myself, you know, sedentary and stuck. And not able to even leave the house. I was so physically and psychologically damaged. And when Fidelco brought Legend into my life, and not just Legend, but all the people at Fidelco have been just, I don't have enough good things to say about the staff, Elliot and Becky, and just everybody, the people that trained and raised those dogs, the, you name it, it's such a huge effort to make it happen. And, but by giving me Legend, it allowed me to live again. It allowed me to have the confidence to get up and get out. It gave me something to do. It gave me a purpose in life. It gave me a reason to get up in the morning because Legend needed to be fed and to go out. And it doesn't matter how bad I feel or how depressed I am or how much pain I'm in. It forced me to have a responsibility that I needed to live up to. And so I attribute Legend was saving my life just as much as any of the doctors did or the combat medics. I don't think I would be here without him and everybody that's helped me get to this point. And I know these things get real solemn, they get heavy, but I just want to say that all my friends that are blind, everybody I know who's lost a limb, taken a bullet, who's dead, my buddy Phil Myers on my wrist, a good friend of mine, all of them love to drink beer, ride motorcycles, listen to heavy metal, and so all of them would say is, yeah, okay, Matt, enough with the tears. Let's ride some motorcycles and laugh and cheer because, you know, that's what we lived for. We don't live for the way we died. We, you know, we want to remember the way we lived and what we fought for and what we gave for, not, you know, not the sad ending to, you know, to try and do something good. So I would say, you know, crank it up, and smile and just ride, because we live in America. And I grew up on the back of BMWs. I rode a ZX6 until I was wounded. I know it's not a Harley. And so, you know, go forth and celebrate. That's my best advice. It's just go forth and celebrate. Thank you, everybody. Keep it on your wheels.
Words to live by. This ride, what we do, serves the living. We, again, believe it's our sacred duty. A couple years ago, our good friends at Honor Remember joined us, because while we serve the living, we also want to remember those who are no longer with us. And we have presented Honor and Remember flags for several years, thanks to the good efforts of Greg Barrett, who was a volunteer to Fidelco for a number of years. And then one of the smartest things I ever did was to bring him on staff as my chief of staff. So I'm very happy about that, and we still are going to present a very special Honor and Remember flag today to a very dear friend, and I'll turn it over to Greg and let him handle it from here. And then Norm's up and we're out.
Thank you. Renee, if I could have you come over to the left here, and if I could have Sandy and my Honor and Remember camaraderie patriots over here on this side. So again, I appreciate your time. Well, just a quick story and a very, very special flag presentation. You've seen Renee Danino up here as the host. Today, she is going to be an honored guest, because the person that we're honoring is her grandfather, and the flag that we're presenting today, the Honor Remember, will be presented in his memory. So if you see Renee crying, give her a big hug. So let me start. December 29, 2005, Norfolk, Virginia. A gentleman named George Lutz answered his front door. On the other side of that front door were two United States Army officers in dress uniform. One was a chaplain. They asked to come in to talk with George, and George had a bad feeling because his son Tony was serving over in Fallujah, Iraq. They sat down with George, and they began the conversation with him and his family that no parent, brother, sister, anybody in the United States ever wants to hear. And those words began with, "We regret to inform you." Draw your attention to my left, your right, and you're going to see the Honor and Remember flag that he created. This is what we call a generic flag. And I'm just going to read the symbolism, and if I could get your attention off to my left here. The Honor and Remember flag's design is distinctive, yet it is simple. Each detail in the flag symbolizes an important part of the overall meaning on this flag's message. The red field represents blood spilled by brave men and women in America's military throughout our history, who gave their lives so that our nation would remain free. The white field below the gold star recognizes the purity of sacrifice. There is no greater price an American can pay than to give his or her life in service to our country. The blue star represents active service in military conflict, and while it originated with World War I, on this flag it signifies service in all wars, from the American Revolution to the present day. The gold star signifies the ultimate sacrifice of a warrior in active service who will not return home. The gold reflects the value of that life that was given. The folded flag signifies the final tribute to an individual life presented to the family for their very significant loss. The flame is an eternal reminder of the spirit that has departed this life, yet burns on in the memory of all who knew and loved the fallen hero. Today, we're honoring Renee's grandfather. I would ask my friend Marvin Goley to just read just briefly about the gentleman that we're honoring today.
It's my extreme honor to read this. U.S. Army Technical Sergeant Frank DeSalvo served during World War II with the 345th Bomb Squadron as a power turret and gun sight mechanic in the Pacific areas of combat. He was awarded the Asiatic Pacific Theater Campaign Medal, the Distinguished Unit Badge with Oak Leaf Cluster, a Good Conduct Medal, and the Philippine Liberation Ribbon with one Bronze Service Star. As a member of the Greatest Generation, we honor the service and sacrifice of Tech Sergeant Frank DeSalvo. God bless you and your family.
I just want to say thank you. My grandfather was my best friend growing up with a single mom, and he never talked about wartime as most veterans don't. He only remembered stories, and his invention actually is still in use today in all current 2017 bombers and planes, and it's been reported that he has saved at this point now, countless lives because of his invention. And I love the Fidelco Guide Dog Foundation, and I love this honor. So thank you to all the veterans in the military out there today. Thank you.
And this flag is presented on behalf of all of the Fidelco friends to Renee.
Thank you, Greg. Renee, Sandy, Sal, thank you. Thank you for being a good friend. All right, who's ready to ride? Norm gets the last word. Okay. Oh, and Lynn asked me to remind everybody, if you had your photo taken here, you can pick it up at the other end after lunch. So they'll be waiting for you. Norm? Did you say something about the last word? Where's Sharon? All right, everybody, you guys ready to ride? What was that? All right, everybody, ride safe. We'll see you guys out at Fidelco for lunch. Elliot's buying. That's what happens when you miss meetings. Thank you, everybody. Ride safe. Rob, thanks so much, Renee, everybody. Ride safe.
You see, they're all getting ready to start out. Lots of bikes here. There they go. They're lining up. They're all lined up. They're leaving from the right to the left.
Wow, isn't this exciting to be here?
Wow.
On the road.
What a ride this has been.
I'm hungry too. Pretty soon we're going to be at the main campus so we can get something to eat and drink.
You said it.
I'm thirsty. It's a little bit hot out with the sun today, so I want some water.
Okay.
And we'd like to thank Fidelco for giving us this opportunity to ride as well here today. Right, Carol?
It's been a lot of fun.
They will put the Harley away for another year.
You got it.
All right.
We are at the Fidelco campus in Bloomfield. We had a great morning over at Gengris in East Hartford. And this is the continuation of the Ride for Independence. You see all the flags here. This is where the riders come in. They park their motorcycles here in the field. All the cars are way behind this big flag, huge flag that's hanging back there. Once again, down here you see the sponsors. So we'd like to thank, and Fidelco thanks, Aetna, Turnpike Motors, HDI, Hartford Distributors, Black Eyed Sally's, Nelligan's, Eversource, Trantolo, and Trantolo. Here we are at the Fidelco Guide Dog Foundation Field of Flags. Look at all the flags that are purchased in honor and in memory of different individuals. There's a banner listing all of the individuals in whose name flags have been purchased. We're pleased to see the Wolcott Lions again. We saw them last week over at our Harbinton Lions Concert for Sight. We saw them last year here at Fidelco. You guys have a wonderful slingshot, I guess.
Slingshot, a Polaris slingshot. This is the SL model. Does about 173 horsepower. I believe it's 62 RPM, if I'm remembering the paperwork correctly.
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
And it's a street-ready vehicle, huh?
Yes, correct, it is. You do not need a motorcycle license. It's considered an auto cycle.
Mm-hmm.
I would recommend wearing a helmet, though. That's me personally, but
always wear
to
a
each
helmet.
Their own, you know?
Did you take it for a test ride?
I haven't yet, but okay. I think there may have been a member or two of the club that snuck a ride. You know, I'm not going to name any names, but, you know.
Well, if you're going to be an effective salesman, you have to know your product.
Well, you need to be able to know. You need to know your product, and we need to know it works. We have to know it works, you know. It's a safety issue. We want to check it out first, probably.
I would suggest, you know, unstrap it, ride it back to Wolcott, let Dad take the truck and the trailer.
That's what I was thinking. I told him that we should have just drove it here in the first place. I don't think the thing should even have a trailer. We should just be driving it around.
Okay. Anyway, we're talking with Joe Hutnick Jr., who we did meet last year, right here. So.
Yes.
And you are a Wolcott Lion.
I am indeed. I think the switching up to the slingshot is probably one of the better moves we've done.
Great. How have sales been?
They've been good. They have definitely been good. I believe last weekend we did about 80 tickets. 79 tickets.
This is at the concert?
That was at the concert. That was very, very surprising. surprising.
That's
yeah,
very
it
good.
Was, it was fantastic.
We had, we had a good crowd. We had, it was
my
wonderful.
Friend Joe Senior, come on out here, Joe.
How are you? Good to see you guys again.
Hey, you know what? We see you. We see you three times a year, and it's all within like a 1 month period. Now we don't see you again for the rest of the year.
I'm in hiding. I get a little tired. No.
We don't get to sneak down. We do sneak down to Wilkett. And we always, when we drive past the fairgrounds, we always look up and think of you guys.
Well, thank you very much. As a matter of fact, the guys are up there working today when we have to pick this up this morning. So.
It looks like they're starting to I can hear some noise in the background. But, you know, we thought we were in Gingras this morning, and we thought that there were fewer motorcycles. But as the morning wore on, they, more and more. I think we're going to have as many as we did last year here.
Yeah, I'm going to tell you, I'm looking forward to it when they all come in, so I'm really happy. It's a great sound when these guys come in.
Yeah,
they all, and they all do this just for Fidelco to raise money so we can give dogs to people with sight impairments and physical handicaps.
And this one specifically for military and first responders.
It's unbelievable. Yeah. So it's, yeah, they do a great job here. They really, really do.
You know, we always like to talk a little bit about Lions. The Lions, we support Fidelco, you know, great organization right here in Connecticut. And site, you know, what better cause is there for Lions and for Lions clubs to give money for Fidelco?
I have to agree with you. It's just, and it's much, much more than just site. I mean, whether it's scholarships, it's assistance for fuel, you know, we do food baskets, and it's not just, I mean, I could speak for my club, but these other clubs, they're all out there, and they get together, and they band together. I remember, when I've been a member for almost 25 years, and every club in the United States, they all chipped in $100, and they brought water to this African village.
Yeah.
So that they could just wipe the eyes of the children out when they were being born. They were going blind when they were 6 months old. And just a little thing like that to bring water in and, you know, so they could wash their hands. You know what I mean? And it's like, it's, and it was
the
just.
Needle,
you know,
the measles initiative. It's $1 to save a kid's life.
I mean, what is it? I mean, they do these, the inoculation for the influenza. It's like 60 cents.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, when you can get together and you get these, everybody bands together. And I tell you, when you see a Lions logo, and you got to realize that the people doing this, they were all volunteering. Like I said, I'm a painter. I don't know half the stuff about this slingshot, but I'm out here raising money up so I can get in and we can do different things. And it's an amazing, amazing thing to be part of that. I mean, you know, by the grace of God, I can sit down, I can write a $100, $200 check to help somebody out.
Mm-hmm.
But when I can do a ZD dinner, I can raise $3,000, $4,000, $5,000, $6,000, $8,000, $10,000.
It's
like, to me, it's a getting to heaven free card. You know what I mean? It's like,
And doing things locally as well as over in Africa or Asia or wherever, you know, that we affect people's lives. We change people's lives everywhere.
You know what I mean? I was at the Middletown show a couple weeks ago, and I was trying to convince a woman to buy a ticket, whatever, okay. And she says, "No, never mind." And I said, "But that's okay. Don't worry about it. If you still need eyeglasses, just call the Lions." And I mean, I don't know why she didn't notice it, but she said, "Lions Club." She said, "I'm buying two." She said, "My son had a sight problem. We didn't have money. Went to the Lions Club, and boom! Within 2 weeks, he had his glasses."
Yep.
And that's what we're about, the Lions Club. And we run on less than 6% administration costs, our charitable arm, which is LCIF, and they're out there, man.
I was president of Lions Low Vision, you know, so we go to these senior centers and people say, well, you know, if you have low vision, how can you drive to get to the low vision center? I say, talk to your local Lions Club. We'll find somebody who can take
it. Absolutely. Yeah, that's it. Yeah, there's no excuses. We find a reason to help you. That's, you know, I mean, you know, granted, when I was answering the phones, a woman needed a hearing aid, and she called me up and she says, you know, well, I talked to my doctor, and he says, well, you know, I'm not going to get a Cadillac. I says, no, but you're going to be able to hear.
Mm-hmm.
And she's, you know, well, it might take time. I says, yeah, we have to do our investigation. We got to make sure we're getting people to volunteer to do this. So, but guess what? We're going to get you your hearing aid, and they did. So, but thanks an awful lot.
Hey, so, thanks. The guys, the people are coming in. Yes, you
Carol,
did.
Carol, it's
all
good
right.
Seeing you. Take care.
The riders have all returned. We just finished the lunch ourselves. Lunch was provided by Black Eyed Sally's, and it was delicious. Here you see a couple of cars being displayed. Beautiful looking cars. You see Carol looking at the Aetna table. Aetna provided pictures this year as the riders were registering. They had their pictures taken. Oh, Carol's waving. Let's see what she thought about the pictures.
Good boy.
Hi, I saw this young lady at Jangris in East Hartford this morning, and I said she did my first blind walk. I've only done two. But
right.
The first one, it was quite a few years ago.
Yes, and I remember you, too.
And it was quite eye-opening, pun intended.
Yes, yep. Yeah.
So I did one in Wilton last summer when they
opened. Oh, nice. Yeah, the new opening, yeah.
Yeah. So that was quite a few years ago. How many years have you been here now?
I've been here for 10.
Wow.
10 in May.
You know, we were looking in the picture at the picture of Roby,
yep.
who died in 2010, and I'm
right.
saying, wow, that was 7 years ago.
I know. It's crazy.
Yeah,
it's
really
crazy. We all miss her, for sure. Yeah.
Oh, yeah. She was like the driving force behind
us. Oh, yeah, for sure.
Definitely. So who do you have here?
This is Finley, mm-hmm. and he's actually brand new. So he came in a couple weeks ago, and I'm just making sure that he can handle a big crowd of people and motorcycles, and it's very good socialization and good evaluation time for all the dogs. So
it's about
a year and a half.
And your name is?
Lindsay.
Okay, Lindsay. So how long will he be here?
He'll be here about 6 to 8 months,
mm-hmm.
Hopefully, if everything goes as planned.
Yeah,
and he'll do everything from learning how to do obstacles to riding buses and escalators and subway training and platform training, traffic training, all kinds of fun things.
Yeah, no, it is truly amazing what you guys do. And we Lions just love to support Fidelco.
Oh, and we love the Lions, for sure.
Great,
we cut into it without all of our volunteers and all the Lions help.
Yeah. Carol and I are now on the New England Lions Advisory Board for Fidelco, so that's great.
Oh, awesome. Yeah. Thank you so much.
Mm-hmm. Okay, great. Well, it's good to see you.
Good to see you, too. Have a good day.
Hi, Janet. How you doing?
I'm fine, thank you. How are you?
We talked. We weren't on air, but about a new puppy.
Oh, waiting for a new puppy. Definitely. Puppy number 14 I'm waiting
14.
For. Yeah.
Is that impressive?
Very impressive.
And your name is?
I'm Zach. I work at Back East Brewery.
We're
right across the street.
Tell us about Back East Brewery.
We've been around for just about 5 years now. We have our anniversary party, 5 years, coming up next month. It's going to be a big bash. And we brought some beer today to donate and sample to the riders.
Very good. And who is this?
Kathy, how are you?
Hi, Kathy. Nice meeting you.
Same here.
And how are you involved with this?
I volunteer in the kennel 2 days a week.
Oh, you do? You're not with the brewery. You're with Fidelco.
I'm with Fidelco. I am a volunteer, and we spread ourselves out to help wherever we can.
That's wonderful. Well, welcome to this event.
Wonderful organization.
I agree. Thanks. Bye, guys.
Thanks.
Bye. Nice seeing you.
Hi again. This Ride for Independence is a wonderful event for Fidelco, isn't it?
It really is. It's like two different events because we spend time at Jangris in East Hartford in the morning, and then we come here to the campus in the afternoon for more music, for the raffle entertainment, for food. The riders come in. They're parked over behind us here in the lawn. We've got all these different flags and things. Talk to a bunch of different people.
Oh,
so
yes.
We really have a great day, and we enjoy all of this.
It's been great. We'll see you all another year here at Fidelco for sure.
So that's going to do it for this episode of Lying Around Connecticut with Carol and Harry. Bye now.
Bye-bye.
We hope you enjoyed our show this evening. Tune in next week for another Lying Around Connecticut with Carol and Harry. Good night.
Bye-bye.